Hi, hello. Today we are going to grow some ginger again. I've been growing it last year. I'm gonna tell you what mistakes I have made, and I'm gonna tell you what results. If you stick with me to the end, you'll see what results I had from last year growing ginger. But this year, because I've learned a few mistakes, I'm going to do a little bit differently. It's a few tips and tricks that can be changed, and you would have much more success. You'll have bigger rhizomes and more production of the ginger. So let's get started. I've got here some compost. It's just normal compost. I put some vermiculite to it, and I'll add some more because ginger doesn't like to sit in soggy water, like in sad compost. So I'm lightening the compost up and using some vermiculite, which you can buy it in garden centers, in B&Q. I bought it from B&Q, I think. My partner bought it. So it works very well with this and with other seeds I've been sowing. Lettuce is the same thing, needs vermiculite in the compost, so it'll grow better. It's something like this, and it's the fine one. And I mix it up with my compost, and then I'm going to fill some trays up. You can see these trays, I've been showing them last year. You can see a video up here. And I fill this up with my mixed compost. So don't fill it up full. Leave a little bit of space for the ginger to lay in. About like this. So you can do in any trays you got, especially if you have some drainage on, then any tray is good. Rule number two with growing ginger. Ginger loves warm places. Like it's like a tropical plant and needs a warm space to grow. That's why it's good to grow in your conservatory, in your greenhouse, or on the windowsill. Rule number three. Ginger to grow and develop big rhizomes and to grow bigger and give you good production, it needs at least 10 months to grow. So it was good to start in January, but I'm starting February. It's still okay because it still has plenty enough months to grow. Here in the UK we don't have too many warm months, so that's why we need to start earlier, keep it in the warm place. And then when in the summer it's warm months, you can keep it, bring it outside the pot or wherever you're growing. And in the autumn, again, I'm going to grow in the glass house, so I should be okay for the autumn because we're gonna put some heating in, but you have to take it back inside when it's coming colder months, especially colder nights. So rule number four, it's actually not a rule, they are all tips, but I'm calling them rules. But let's say tip number four. When you have the ginger and planning to plant it, you break the pieces. Doesn't have to be very big. So it's good to leave them to just dry a little bit. Like leave them for a few hours so the wound will dry. Otherwise, when you put them in the compost, they can go rotten from here. I've got here some ginger and they need to have some eyes. They called nodes, actually. I'm calling them eyes, but they actually called nodes, these little ones. So these nodes, it's very important to have them because they're from where the shoot will start growing and there where the ginger starts actually growing and developing. We done that. Now it's time to plant them. Thank you. bit of compost over them just to cover them up. Number five is water them, but don't water them too much. Don't make them soaking in water. So just get the compost moist. That's all we need. So tip number six, cover the trays up with cling film. This will keep the moisture in the trays, and you don't have to water them anymore, and they will just have the chance and moist enough to develop the eyes, to grow the shoots. So let's get started. Put them in a warm place. So I'm going to take one of these trays into the house on the windowsill just above my radiator, so this will get chance for this ginger to get warmed up and start growing. Having the cling film on top, this will just help the moisture not to evaporate so quick, and then they sit in the dry compost, because compost can dry very quick. So this is a good tip and a good trick to keep the moisture in. I'm gonna show you my failures and what I done wrong from last year. So what have I done wrong from last year when I've been growing my ginger? The only wrong thing I think I've done, I didn't allow enough months for the ginger to grow, because the ginger to develop and to make nice rhizomes, like bigger bulbs, shall I say, it needs at least 10 months to grow. So it must be planted somewhere in January, or even the latest it's February, because here in UK we don't have too many months of warm weather. So that's why we need to get it inside and finishing off growing, and allow and starting inside as well. Last year I've been planted I've planted my ginger in somewhere in April, which was a bit late. Then I've potted up into the pots from the trays about middle of June, which again was far too late. I've harvested, you can see here when I've harvested in November, and here you can see it wasn't successful at all. It had very small rhizomes and not big, not developed much at all. It had leaves, yes, it had stalks, It was nice. We used them in tea. Mom dried them and using them in making tea because they still have a lot of aroma. But my rhizomes, my actual ginger, didn't develop enough. If I would have had another few months, you can see there, it would have been nice. But I didn't have the months because it's gone cold. And last year in November, we didn't hit the glass house. So that's why it wasn't a big success. So I'll know for this year. I've started much earlier. So that's why I'm suggesting to you, start early, put them in the windowsill and start growing them in the house. Bring them out for a few months and then you'll take them in again in the autumn when it starts to be cold. This amount of ginger has been harvested from 2 pots, and of course it's not too much. The rhizomes are small. So that's it for my ginger. That's all I had. That's the mistakes you can make in growing ginger. Unless you grow it in the house all the time, it still needs a little bit of light. So some growing lights might be handy. So that's how it's to start growing your ginger. I hope you find this interesting. Thank you very much for sticking with us, for watching my videos. If you've got any questions, I'll be happy to answer them. If you want us to try to grow anything else, I'll be happy to do another video, because this is our main job. We're growing things, growing veggies and fruits, and I'm happy to try anything new, to explore anything new. I'm very happy about that. So please give us a comment, tell us what you would like to see, and we'll do that. Bye for now. See you next time. Bye.